Hello, everyone, and thank you so much for joining me today. I'm Jaylene, and this is Just Ask Jay. Probably the best little blog you'll ever find to answer the questions that you have in regards to what it is that you've always wanted to ask a medium but were afraid to. You have some great questions, and I found myself looking at more or less the ones about crossing over, what happens next. And I had some great questions from Ashley, April, and Karen. And so I'm going to go over those. And of course, I put the questions down as they were written so that you can see where they came from. And I'm going to answer them. So, first of all, Ashley, thank you so much for writing, and especially for the cute little heart. But I have to say, I was so happy when you wrote about just wondering if it truly has to be a year after a loved one passes to actually cross over. So I don't know where you heard that from, but oh my God, could you imagine? I'm gonna be able to do my job. I'm gonna tell you, there has been experiences where I had a lady come to see me in a group session, and there were 10 people there, and I was channeling her son who had just passed away not even 24 hours before. In fact, they were just planning the funeral. It was the very night before that she came out for her session, and I had asked her, "Why did you come out for this session today?" And she says, "You know, Jay," she says, "there's a reason why I made this appointment, and I was going to cancel and decided not to. I've done a reading for someone years ago on the telephone, and I asked her, are you going to the wake tomorrow?" And she said, "Yes, the wake is tomorrow." And we delayed it about a month. But I knew that already because of what I was hearing from the other side. So I got to tell you, there's different ways of crossing through, and everybody has their own experience. First of all, there's five exits to a human soul. So we have five ways of dying. And sometimes you're going to be very unconscious in that passing. So, like, in other words, I might have gotten hit by a transport truck from behind. I have no clue that I've died. Those spirits may be stuck a little bit because they think that they're still dreaming. They haven't really crossed through on the other side yet. So they're really not realizing that they've passed away. Or suicides. Now, suicides could take a little while longer because I believe that those are broken agreements. If I was supposed to be, let's say, married to someone and they saw me hugging someone that they thought I was cheating on them, and they go home and I find that they've passed away because they took an overdose or something, and I read a letter, "Dear Jay, I did that because I thought you were having an affair and I couldn't live my life without you," and you realized, "Oh my God, I was hugging my cousin I haven't seen in 20 years at the store." A, that person, of course, has some mental health issues because they've taken their life. I mean, you just don't take your life because of those things, but let's just assume this is what happened. If I did that and I was supposed to be married to someone, that person that I was supposed to marry probably never had the three kids that they were supposed to have. They didn't learn about the lessons they were here to learn. They didn't learn about the sex, drugs, and rock and roll and the tough love that they should have gone through with those kids. There's so many different things that they didn't experience. So essentially, that soul, I believe, stays behind and has to basically step in everybody's shoes that they've so affected by taking their own life, because it's not on the how-to list of dying. We have five ways of dying. That's not one of them. And then, of course, and of course, the person that commits suicide, just have to add this, does eventually go through to the other side once they've accepted their karmic lessons, once they've, seen how that death has affected other people. And of course, there are accidental passings, overdoses, that kind of thing. They kind of go in the same category as, "Oh my God, did I just die?" type thing, and that happens. Suicide's a little bit different, but they do go through. Now, when a person crosses through, it's instant. When you die, you are instantly on the other side. It's not like a 20-minute process that you have to take the elevator to heaven to get there. You're just there, and that's it. So, what's really nice about that is you do transform through, but I believe that those souls have an unawareness for about 3 human days, because there's no time, there's no space, there's no male, there's no female on the other side. There's none of that. It's like being in a dream, and when you're in a dream, you're very unaware of your surroundings, you're in the moment. So it's like being stuck in a beautiful dream, and then all of a sudden you realize, "Oh geez, I don't think I'm going back." So, and then those who know they're passing know they've died, and they readily accept. But again, takes about 3 days for that soul and human time to kind of realize or wake up or kind of accept that's where they are. And they don't have the same ego as we do, so that's another subject altogether, but they don't miss us when they go there. They have an unawareness, just like being in a dream. So when you die, you won't even know you died. And then it's going to be like, oh my God, like I have to figure this out. And that's exactly what happens. You have to kind of figure it out. But such a great question, and thank you so much, Ashley. And if people want to expand on that or talk to each other about it, whatever, please feel free. This is the forum to do it. I wanted to go next to April Penna. Thank you, April. Thank you so much for, participating in Just Ask Jay. And I have here, hey Jay, I was wondering, or I've always wondered, if anyone who's crossed over ever want to come back, like if they did not do what they came here to do. And I'm going to tell you, I believe in recycled souls. People call them reincarnations. I call them recycled souls because that's the N word for J. But I do believe that we can recycle our way back into this life, but not necessarily to, learn the things that we didn't maybe learn the first time around. Everybody has a life purpose, April, and it's interesting that you asked that question, but everybody has a life purpose. Everybody is here to do something. And even though you're not aware of that, even though you don't know what the hell you're doing here on Earth, I'm going to tell you straight up, everybody is living their purpose, even though they're not aware. And your purpose could have been to wake up this morning and have an effect on someone's total stranger's life. And you've changed that person's life and you've done the job that you're meant to do. But some souls, let's say like a suicide, some of them don't want to come back. Once they've crossed through the light and they've done their little time in between, they don't want to come back. Some of them don't, some do. And I believe that every soul that comes here, because this is the planet of tribulation, where the soul comes here to learn their lesson, I believe that once we cross back to our home, we have a conscious awareness whether we want to come back or not, because on that side, you know everything. But I do believe that souls that come back time and time again come back at a higher elevation. So I believe that some of them choose very, very difficult life paths, or they choose a more difficult life in order to be able to learn selflessly, I can't even say that word today, selflessly, what it is that they're intended to learn. So at the end of the day, that soul, before it comes here, it doesn't have a human ego, so it knows exactly what it needs to learn to graduate to a higher soul level once it's gone back home. So at the end of the day, it's totally a soul decision, but a lot of them don't want to come back, and they don't. And that is totally a decision. Some of them, they do want to come back, and some can come back as many times as they want. And it's interesting. It's just kind of a different consciousness here. But you won't remember being born. You won't remember dying. So you won't remember your past lives. And some people do past life regression, hypnotherapy, different things like that. You'd be surprised what comes out of that. But consciously speaking, we don't know if we're going to come back, but the soul knows definitely whether it does, April. But such a great question, and something we could talk and talk and talk about, because so many people have different opinions about this. But that is basically what I've learned from recycling through, because I believe that I remember two past lives, or that they kind of follow me somehow. And I've spoken to hypnotherapists and I've gone through that, and there's one definitely that comes out quite clearly. And it's interesting to see, the influences of those lives and what I'm doing today. So it's kind of interesting. I find that sometimes they can go hand in hand, and sometimes the lessons will be totally different. So thank you so much for asking. Claire, Karen Claire Koski is the next person that asked, and she said, is it possible for a person to have no one on the other side? And have you ever met your ancestors or felt you establish any strong bonds? And I thought that was such a good question. Thank you so much, Karen. Because when I had my near-drowning accident, I had an accident in 1964, a long, long time ago. And the first thing I remember, when I believe I went to the other side, because it was like a dream for me. So, I was 4 years old, but this is what I remember. I remember seeing my grandfather. My grandfather died 8 years before I was born, but it was like someone had implanted a little chip in my head, and I had an instantaneous knowing of who he was, what happened to him, who he belonged to, who he loved, who every little facet of his being, I instantly knew. Now, this is a man I have never met while I was alive because he had died years before I was born, but yet I knew who that was. Even though going through the light, I had hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of beautiful lights reaching out for me and trying to touch me, but I felt love like I never had before. And when you're four, you're not supposed to know what love is, but I was just so overjoyed and so like, so full of love. I still remember that. I had no awareness of my mom and dad. I had no awareness of anything on this side of the fence. So when I crossed through, I didn't know I had a mom and dad. I didn't know I had a brother and sister. I didn't know I had a dog or a house or toys or friends or that I went to school. I had no awareness. And when I saw my grandpa, I knew who he was. It's just amazing. So I believe that everybody has somebody on the other side. And if you don't have any relatives, let's say, because some spirits don't have to hang out with other spirits, trust me. Some energies are not intended to be together. They're here to go through certain life lessons. Soulmates could be great or they could be terrible. So, and they're here to learn new lessons, yays or nays. That's just the way it works. But if I were to have to go to the other side, I don't have to hang around with certain relatives, but I'm going to tell you, we're like on the big disco ball of life. If you had to think about it, Karen, a big disco ball has thousands of mirrored facets, which I'm going to use as this is I am. I am one. And all those little mirrored facets on the disco ball is like a soul. So we're all connected. You and I are connected even to the other side. And a lot of people don't see that, but we separate ourselves. We learn what it is that we need to learn, and then we go back to this big disco ball, and then we just shine a little brighter. So in other words, that consciousness grows stronger and stronger and stronger, and we're united on the other side. We're all as one, although we're different spirits and we're different facets. Every mirror shines in its own brilliance. But I guess the point I'm trying to make is that when we go back to that big disco ball, we're really quite all one. We are all united. That's why we need to be good to each other, because if we're not good to each other, we're essentially just hurting ourselves by being mean to other people. So always be good to others and express kindness, because I'm going to tell you, it will come back to bite you somehow. But, you know, Karen, I hope you understood that we always have someone to the other side. We are created from our creators. My creator is my mom and dad. That's who my gods are, trust me. And the thing is, at the end of the day, you know, you had to have someone create you. So essentially, when they die, they go to the other side. There will be someone there. You will recognize them, even though you never met them, which is kind of interesting. And that was my experience at the age of four. I was able to tell my mother my grandfather's date of death. I knew what he did. I knew what he looked like. I knew his favorite horse because he had his favorite horse with him. I mean, it was just amazing. And, you know, what can I say? But I've, you know, belonged to over 250 near-death groups in the last 25 to 30 years. And I'm going to tell you, a lot of people have met their relatives, people they never knew. A lot of times when I channel through for people, I'll have, you know, someone that I'm talking to, and they'll say, oh my God, that was my great-great-grandmother. I never met her, of course, but everything you've told me is actually what she's lived or what she's done. So they do come through in readings as well. It's kind of interesting. But anyways, they can definitely be our spirit guides as well. So Karen, you know, I would ask your loved ones, even if you don't know who they are, you can ask them for guidance and help, because I believe that they are our spirit guides. Anyways, I hope that all of you enjoyed this very first little segment of Just Ask Jay and answering questions about crossing over. You know, I'm going to try to get on there and answer a couple questions too, but please feel free to ask your questions below this video. I'm so freaking pumped to do this. I'm telling you, if I could do it like every day, I would. But anyways, I absolutely love all your questions. Thank you so much for participating, and I'm looking forward to answering all of your questions on the next Just Ask Jay. Take care. Bye-bye.